Here we are on the Harvard campus, a boy and a girl. I'm the boy.
You know your little Penelope wants to marry you, darling. But first, go out west and collect your inheritance, the vast fortune your father left you.
Very few people recognize me from this angle. Rather classic head, haven't I? You should see it when they take the cork out. But enough chit-chat. On with the story. This girl is mad about me.
No, don't kiss me.
Imagine any girl saying that to me. Silly child. I like to kiss this girl because she has just the kind of lips I like. One on top and one on the bottom.
Go now, Junior. Get your money. And remember, I love you. Love you. Love you.
I'm about to turn toward you lucky people. Fasten your safety belts. Don't be impatient and please, no applause. You might miss the plot.
Magna cum laude.
Magna cum laude. That's Latin, meaning if you folks drive home after the show, be sure and use a car. Uh-uh. What's this? This is an old character actor on the Paramount lot we try to keep working. He's supporting a large family. But I guarantee you this fellow will not be in the picture tonight. Well, sir, on with the show.
I'll be waiting. And though you face grave danger, be brave. Be fearless. For remember, darling, you are Junior, son of Paleface.
Thank you.
afternoon, Governor Freeman.
Hi, Doc.
Roy.
Hello, Roy.
Well, we were on our way to meet you. Why this?
I used the servant's entrance. You see, Governor, when I'm assigned to a case, I trust no one, not even your personal guards.
Seems to me we got the right man, Doc.
That's what I told you, Governor. What's your plan, Roy?
The plan is to wait and watch. I don't think we'll have to wait too long. You see, all the holdups have taken place in this area. And with the gold stolen at these points, I figure the town of Sawbuck Pass must be the Torch's headquarters. Doc, I'll meet you there in the morning and we'll get things set up.
I'll be there.
Now be careful, Roy. If the Torch ever finds out that you and Doc are federal agents, you'll never get out alive.
We have before. You see, Governor, I disguise myself with a song and Doc hides behind a bottle of patent medicine. I'll see you later.
We're off to Sawbuck Pass.
Hold it, Trigger. Lou, a four-legged friend, a four-legged friend. He'll never let you down. He's honest and faithful right up to the end. That wonderful one, two, three, four-legged friend. A woman's like cactus and cactus can hurt, 'cause she's just a tight-waisted, winky-eyed flirt. She'll soon have your land and your pride and your gold, and bury you deep long before you grow old. A four-legged friend, a four-legged friend, he'll never let you down.
He's honest and faithful right up to the end. That wonderful one, two, three, four-legged friend.
Gentlemen, my partner and his four-legged friend have told you only a few of the curative powers of Doc Lovejoy's Wonder Tonic. Now, who's going to be the first one to waltz up here and purchase a clean bill of health for only $1?
Hey, Doc, I'd like to buy a bottle for the sheriff. He's suffering from torch trouble.
That ain't funny, mister.
Ain't funny having bandits stealing our gold. It's getting so nobody's safe. The next thing you know, the Torch will be riding in and shooting up the town.
Somebody must be smoking the full pack.
Folks, it's only me. Only me. That's the understatement of the year. Well, we must move ahead. There we go. Oops, sorry.
A scratch. Look, a scratch on my mudguard. Sheriff, where's the sheriff here?
I'm the sheriff.
Oh, you're the man? Well, sheriff, run down to the corner and get me a crooked lawyer.
How do you like that?
Look at that fellow rolling in the mud. Arrest him for drunk driving. I'm an innocent man, and if you have any justice in you, you'll accept my bribe.
What's the big idea? Look what you did to our wagon and my horse.
Quarantine that beast. He's got chicken pox.
Listen, you.
Please.
Lips that touch liquor shall never touch mine.
I never touched a drop in my life.
Yeah, somebody's been putting bourbon in your toothpaste.
Boy, you...
Get your hands off of me. I'm engaged to be married. And you stop puckering up. I wouldn't kiss you either. Now, look, Sheriff, I want... Please, no dancing.
Just a minute. Now, you'll pay for that wagon, stranger, or you'll go to the hoosgow.
The hoosgow? Oh, the hoosgow. Hold on, you can't put a Harvard man in jail. It's unsanitary.
What are you going to pay for that wagon with?
A preposition at the end of a sentence. And you split your infinitive. Next thing you know, you'll be dangling his participle. Oh, shame on you. The schoolmarm will certainly hear about this, sir. Now, can one of you peasants direct me to the bank? I'm here to claim the inheritance left to me by my daddy, Paleface Potter.
You Paleface's son?
You're staring right at him.
Hey, Lim! Son of Paleface is here!
Paleface?
Son of Paleface!
Hurry up, they're gonna read the will.
Come on, he's gonna get his money.
And so I, Paleface Potter, the greatest Indian fighter ever to hit the West, being of sound mind, do bequeath to my son, Junior, my entire fortune. The reason I leave all of my money to my son, Junior, is that being of sound mind, I won't bother to read the last paragraph, Junior. It's merely an expression of your father's love for you, his son.
Oh, just a minute. I was so young at the time, I don't remember many of the things that Daddy said about me. If he poured out his heart in this will, I'd kind of like to read it. The reason I leave all of my money to my son, Junior, is that being of sound mind, I can't leave my money to my wife because I ain't never forgiven her since the day she presented me with an idiot for a son. Well, I was the only child, you see. But this idiot is all I got in the world, which shows you what a lousy spot I'm in. Never knew Dad felt that way about me. I always knew I was kind of a schnook, but I'm a nice schnook, ain't I? Even at Harvard, I took a course in good schnookery.
I'm sorry, Junior.
All Dad's friends like me. What a reception. All those smiling faces out there.
Some of those faces out there aren't smiling, Junior. You see, your father left town in a hurry. He left owing a lot of bills to a lot of people. They expect to be paid out of the money you inherit. There's your father's chest, Junior. It hasn't been moved since he put it there. Here's the key.
Oh, it's a Yale lock. Wish I had my gloves.
Mr. Stoner, can I see you a moment?
Right away, Weaverly. I'll be right back, Junior. They should be ashamed of themselves. For his sake, I hope he finds a lot of gold.
The way that mob's acting, he'll need it.
Look at that big fella with the block and tackle. Why, they'll tear him limb from limb. Oh.
This whole thing makes me sick at my stomach.
Well, Junior will be worse than sick at his stomach if he doesn't rush that gold out here. You hold him off. I'll go get him.
Gold. Thousands of gold dollars. Gold. Gold. I got gold. It's all there. Gold slippers, gold trinkets. My daddy's gold. Oh, I got gold rocks, gold stones, gallstones, gold gallstones. I'm rich.
Steady.
I got millions, I tell you.
Junior, steady, boy.
Yeah, I'm all right.
Weaverly, come here, quick.
Yeah, Weaverly, Weaverly. Right, gold.
Come on.
I got gold. Now I can afford a gabardine head for summer. Gold. I got millions.
I say we string him up right now.
We'll never get paid.
He's got tricky eyes like his old man.
My bill has been due over 30 years.
Yeah.
Folks, please listen to me.
Mr. Potter is suffering from shock. The sight of all that money in his father's strong box was just too much for him. Now, your bills will all be paid within 2 days according to the terms of Paleface's will. Should I take you to your hotel, Mr. Potter?
Mr. Potter, Mr. Potter, Mr. Potter. Can't anyone call me Nuggets?
We want our money.
Money!
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 Darling, they're playing our song.
He won the West. If he won it, he was using loaded dice.
My daddy. How can I ever thank you for all the money you left me? And I know you didn't mean to die, Daddy mine, without paying your bills. You just kind of keeled over before you could open your big, fat Western wallet. And I know you're happy up there, branding those stray angels and plucking on your harp and singing Buttons and Bows and ka-ya-yippee-ya-yo-ya-yo.
Kill my brain. Now, Yellow Cloud kills son of Paleface.
How?
How?
Me like 'em send message, my girl Penelope. Harvard University, Boston, Mass. Care tool house, girl's entrance.
Message?
Me found no money. Me plenty trouble. You borrow money. Send plenty. Sign. Sam Pontiac. Heap big chief, Sam Pontiac.
Here. Wampum. Hey, chief. Here's your answer. It says, you got him no money. You get lost. Signed, Heap Big Penelope.
The big double-crossing little heap. And to think she was gonna be mother of my idiot papoose. I hope she can't keep up the payments on the ring. Thanks for the wardrobe. Never trust any fillies from Boston. Presumed height. Watch that. Wow, I was just checking his hat size. 8.5 AA. Thank you. See, I'm donating a large portion of my vast wealth to philanthropic charities, and I'm going to see to it that every horse gets a new Easter outfit. I'm sorry those striped trousers won't be ready till tomorrow. See, I have to cut a hole on the bias so he can get his tail through. Wouldn't be comfy walking around with a seat full of hair. Well, time's a-wasting, and I have to get down to the livery stable for more fittings.
Livery stable? So you can get into your horseless carriage and get battled out of town before your 2 days is up.
You're just like your old Paul. He was the lionest, crookedest, mangiest, ruttenest, low-down critter that never drew a sober breath.
Say, you really knew my daddy, didn't you? You, sir, have cast aspersions on my dear old daddy. That brave, low-down, mangy, crooked, drunken hero who won the West. And if you weren't as weak and as old as you are weak and old, aren't you? You are. Put up your dukes. Come on, in the name of my dear old daddy, who lies sleeping in a far-off fossil cemetery, I demand satisfaction. If I didn't defend the honor of the Potter name, my daddy would turn over in his grave.
Nobody's gonna have any suspicion of two fellas hanging around just to get their wagon fixed. Lucky this dude bumped into us.
You know, I've got a hunch he's gonna run us into some more luck.
Huh? Good evening. How's our wagon coming along?
That'll be ready for tomorrow.
That soon, huh? We figured you might be too busy seeing to it that that college fellow didn't sneak out of town.
If he tries to leave town, I'll smash his brains in.
I wouldn't do that. You might get in trouble with the law. Be just as easy to unfix his transportation. Oh, we'll be seeing you.
You kind of got interested in young Potter's son like, didn't you, Roy?
You know, Doc, I'm interested in a lot of things. I'm interested in music. And I'm interested in keeping Mr. Potter in town. Unless I miss my guess, his father's gold will create a lot of interest with a certain party.
$5,000.
And I know where the next bundle's coming from.
Since when are you making the plans?
Something you ought to know, Mike. This afternoon, I know.
I know. A couple of strangers. Medicine men dropped into town.
I don't mean them. I mean a fella called...
Junior Potter came from the east to get his father's gold. All right, fellas. I'll take care of Mr. Junior Potter. This is gonna be my own private party.
Where do I come in?
Don't ever come to a party unless you're invited. Forget about Mr. Potter. As soon as I get him under a full moon, I'll empty his father's chest.
So you see, boy, that's how I know that chest of your paws was as empty as his head.
Dad's head wasn't empty. I know because Mother used to rattle it for me when I was a baby.
Your paw and me were partners, boy. Paleface Potter and Ebenezer Hawkins. Prospecting by day and prospecting by night.
Hey, tell me about the nights.
Take some.
Haven't you got the demitasse size?
You look pale. The color's left your cheeks.
I know. My blood's going down in my hip pocket to count my money.
Your paw wouldn't put his gold in the bank. He didn't trust banks. He was too crafty for that. But he hid the gold somewhere.
This water's warm.
Well, then your paw had to get back to Boston before he had a chance to tell me where he hid the gold. But he must have told you.
Oh, Dad was too crafty to tell anything to an idiot.
Oh, stop feeling bad, boy. You got to start thinking. Your paw must have said something. You got to remember where he hid his gold. Because if we find it, boy, we'll be rich. Gold, gold, millions, billions, gold, gold. I got gold shut eyes. Gold, gold.
Steady, Ev, we did that bit.
Now, you've got to start thinking.
No wonder that water was warm.
Hey, Doc, there goes our bait.
Sure good to hear you intend to settle down in Sawbuck Pass, boy. Smile, smile.
Oh, yes. Yes, I've been thinking seriously of squandering my fantastic fortune here. Sort of endow a college, branch of Harvard. Sawbuck Annex with a built-in lampoon.
We better stick close.
Yeah, if you're right, he should lead us to the torch.
I remember the time that Daddy was telling me about when he fought a redskin with one hand tied behind his back. Beat him to a pulp, too. Of course, it might have been a different story if that redskin hadn't had one hand tied behind his back. Oh, Daddy loved killing Indians. He didn't consider his day complete unless at least one redskin bit the dust. Some of those dopey-looking Indians bit so much dust they had to brush their teeth with a whisk broom. I thought you were wood, like the... You've heard of wooden Indians, huh? Come in. Sorry, no table without a reservation. You get it? Reservation? That's a joke, like, and... Well, you see, I'm the son of Paleface. You've heard of Paleface, the great Eskimo fighter? Hated Eskimos. Hated them. See, they taught him how to rub noses, and I inherited this. This is what I was, well, don't take any wooden Indians. I mean wooden nickels. That reservation's pretty funny, you know. You got sort of the truth. Oh, well. See, that's the big difference between Dad and me. Having an education, I believe in letting Indians live. See, poor old Dad never had any schooling. He was a self-made moron. Of course, I'm different. I only associate with intellectuals. Well, this sounds like an intellectual joint. Glad you got your formal on.
Doing?
Fine, boy. We got him fooled. Now keep acting like your porous chest is loaded, but keep thinking.
I keep thinking it isn't. Well.
Millionaire?
Well, I've been making speeches all day and I'm a little tired, but I guess you want me to say a few words.
The drinks are on Junior Potter!
Those weren't the words.
Now act like you got millions. Sign the checks like your pa used to. And remember, you're not a mouse, you're a man.
You peaked.
Give this millionaire something that'll put hair on his chest.
I got hair on my chest. Give me something that'll part it in the middle.
What do you have?
I'll have a horse's neck.
How about you?
No use killing two horses.
Your father's favorite drink. One pale face special. Coming up.
What are you having, a straight celery tonic? Glad you wrote that letter to Santa.
Did you think of anything yet?
I'll say. She's really got it.
She's got what?
I don't know, but if we could bottle it, we could make a fortune.
I'm shouting, I'm singing. Tonight I'll do some flinging. Time to stop the show. I'm laughing, I'm humming, because I know what's coming. Things have been too slow, and now I'll make them go. What a night for a wing-ding. My baby's more than willing to make the evening thrilling. Things are right for a wing-ding. And I can tell you, you can count on me. I got the mate I'm dating, waiting patiently. I'm sprucing up to loosen up and have a spree. I'm for him and figure he's for me. Tonight'll be a beauty. Yep. Tahooty, what a time to be tingling. I'll soon be flying higher than a kite, because tonight's my night to have a wing ding. There'll be real fine doings tonight.
Bury this kid, he's dead. What's the matter? Don't you like girls?
I'll stick the horses, mister.
Horses. Horses? Horses. That's ridiculous.
I got the mate I'm dating, waiting patiently. I'm sprucing up to loosen up and have a spree. I'm for him and figure he's for me. Tonight'll be a beauty. Yep, Tahuti, what a time.
What a time.
To be tingling. I'll soon be flying higher than a kite. Because tonight's my night to have a wing ding. There'll be real fine doings. We'll leave the town in ruins.
The boss of this place. She's rich.
Rich? You mean she's got money, too?
She's tops around California.
She's not so bad around North and South Dakota, either.
How about California roads?
Cloud in my valley of sunshine.
Am I in love?
Hold it, fellas, one at a time.
Let's have buttons and bows. That's a favorite song of my wealthy daddy, Paleface Potter.
Some melancholy baby.
What would you like, Mr. Potter?
What would I like? Can't we discuss the matter in a nice, quiet place like the cellar of my hotel? Or maybe you'd like to take a stroll through the rock quarry. You see, at college, I majored in geology and anthropology and running out of gas in Bunker Hill. What's your name, honey?
Well, my friends call me Mike.
That's a pretty masculine handle for such a feminine pot of goodies. Mind if I take potluck?
Maybe the gal don't want to be bothered.
Sir, I resent this intrusion. You have the nerve, the audacity, the guts to... Pardonnez-moi, madame. You have the guts to interrupt this tete-a-tete. Again, pardonnez-moi, madame. Now, vamoose, cherchez. Now, let's see, where were we?
Put that gun away.
Yeah, let that be the thought for today.
He ought to blow out his yellow liver.
Blow out my liver? You'd mess up the onions.
Put it away.
You heard her. Give me back my yellow liver. It matches my spine.
You know I don't believe in shooting.
Someday you'll be sorry you're so tender-hearted.
Tender heart never won tender liver, I always say. Guess I was pretty stern with him. Now, about that deal in the cellar.
Excuse me, ma'am.
You're excused.
I'm talking to the lady.
What do you think I'm talking to, a duck?
Just a minute. Let the man talk.
We don't need him.
Yes?
I happen to know the song the stranger requested. Would you like to sing it?
Fine, fine.
Oh, here we go. What do you got in your pockets?
Excuse me.
Horses yet?
A western ranch is just a branch of nowhere junction to me. Give me the city where living's pretty and the gals wear finery. East is east and west is west, and the wrong one I have chose. Let's go where you'll keep on wearing those frills
and flowers and buttons and bows,
rings and things and buttons and bows.
Tough as nails, hard as bricks, Harvard class of 96.
Don't bury me in this prairie, take me where the cement grows.
Eastern stuff ain't nearly rough enough. I'm the brute who's wrecking the jails, chewing the bars and spitting out nails. I was peaches, I was cream, I was captain of the team.
Oh, give me a he-man who's sharp as broken glass.
I was known as Harvard's toughest coot, the scourge of Boston, Mass. Rock 'em, sock 'em, make 'em quit, hit 'em where they know they're hit.
In days gone by, they used to sign for the city fashion show.
Now I wear coyote underwear, I use bullets to button my clothes, and tie my shoes with rattlesnake bows.
Bullets for buttons and snakes for bows?
Well, I'm so mean, I hate myself.
Give me eastern trimming where women are women in high silk hose and peekaboo clothes and French perfume that rocks a room. You're all mine in buttons and bows.
I love coffee, I love tea, I love the girls and I love me.
You're all mine in buttons and bows.
Never made the Harvard crew, won my letter in a canoe.
You're all mine in buttons and bows.
Kissed a
a girl when I was 10. Darned if I ain't ready again.
You're all mine in buttons and...
When I was 12, oh, what a joy. Mom told me I was a boy.
You're all mine in buttons and...
After the dance, we parked in an alley. I wonder what's become of Sally.
You're all mine in buttons and...
You'll have a great big smack if you give my beanbag back.
You're all mine in buttons and...
You're a doll and I'm a dandy. Let's chip in for cotton candy.
You're all mine in buttons and bows.
Well, let's have it. Here's mud in my throat. Put a head on it.
Junior Potter, boy millionaire. Can I come in?
I'm taking a bath.
Oh, can you come out? I mean, when you're through taking the bath. I'd like to take you for a little spin in my horseless carriage, and we could park in some nice dark spot, and I could show you the luminous dial on my watch. I mean, we could palaver and sort of figure out the best way to lavish my rich daddy's fortune on you.
Oh, I'd love to talk about your daddy's gold. But don't get the idea I'm mercenary. I like you for yourself, Junior. The way you look, well, I think you're the handsomest man in the world.
Oh, well, I wouldn't say that, but I appreciate your honesty. Well, now that I know how you feel about me, I want to relieve your mind and tell you that I'm not going to play hard to get. Before you know it, you'll be kissing me full on my soft, warm, red lips. Oh, how I'll envy her.
I'd be very happy to take a ride with you, Junior, as soon as I get out of the tub.
Out of the tub? Really? You should have heard that line.
No. No, I couldn't do it. Wouldn't be fair. I'd be a cad. Besides, my eyeball might get stuck.
Look, let's go. My car is parked down at the livery stable.
I'll meet you there at midnight. You run along now, Junior.
Oh, no, I wouldn't think of leaving you unprotected like this. You being in the water. A couple of Annapolis men might come along, and well, you know how those sailors are, anchors away and all that. No, I'll stand right here and guard your door, little lady.
Hot, two, three, four. Hot, two, three, four, a windy. My baby's more than willing to make the evening thrilling. Things are right for a weaning, and I can tell you, you can count on me. I got the maid I'm dating, waiting patiently.
I'm sprucing up to loosen up and have a spree.
I'm for her and figure she's for me. Tonight'll be a beauty.
Yep, tahoody.
Yes?
Goodbye.
You got no time for romance, boy. You gotta think.
I've been doing plenty of thinking. I didn't go to college 14 years for nothing. I got it all figured out. It just so happens the richest girl in town is crazy about me.
You mean Mike?
By tomorrow, she'd be Mrs. Mike Potter. Don't you get it? I marry her. This is California, community property. I divide her money.
With my half, I'll pay my stingy old daddy's bills. The rest is gravy.
But we'll have that woman on our hands.
Please, keep your hands out of my gravy. Now, if you give me your word you'll take a bath, you can be my best man. Well, here we go.
Where is it?
Open them up wide, Eb. I'm gonna whiz on to fame and fortune.
Gravy, gravy.
So long, Eb. Say, you've grown in the last few minutes.
I ain't growed. They took your tires, boy, to keep you from getting out of town.
Took my tires? How dare they? Don't they realize I'm a Harvard man and my gravy's getting cold?
Where are they?
My tires, where are they?
They're up there, Junior, chained to the rafters.
How do you like that? Now I'll have to cancel my date till tomorrow night. It's not human for a girl to wait 24 hours, even for me. Why, you four-legged glue pot. I hope all your children have fat-mounted policemen on them. I was only joking.
No sense of humor. Spread out.
Manager! Where's the manager?
Don't get up, madam. I just came in to use your window.
Your plans are working out, Roy.
I need your help, Governor.
Anything I can do.
All right. Start those gold shipments moving again tonight.
Tonight? Oh, that's dangerous, Roy, until you get your man.
Man? There's romance in the air, Governor. I figure it's about time I got myself a gal.
Wowee. Live a little, that's my motto.
I'm rubbing, I'm tubbing, I'm brushing and I'm scrubbing. Shine from head to floor. I'm laughing, I'm humming, cause something great is coming. And my friend, what's more, it's just outside my door.
What a night for a wingding. I've got the Harvard spirit. Just listen and you'll hear it stand and fight. Have a wingding and wear the crimson colors ever bright.
I'm gonna tackle her like she's a Princeton bat. Keep dipping like I'm ripping up the Yale attack. Hurtle like I'm on the Dartmouth track.
They'll all remember Potter. Hail alma mater, what a time.
Stupid tingling. Fair Harvard never saw a brighter sight.
Because tonight's my night to have a winning. I will win for Harvard tonight.
I love soap and I love water. Makes me smell just like I order.
I will win for Harvard tonight.
Oh, you want to tintype the fabulous millionaire, huh?
Well, go right ahead.
Come, boy, let's not waste any time. Who do you think you are, Cecil B. DeMille?
Somebody call me?
Well, you could have fooled me.
Yeah, well, what's the little Betty? Ready, boy?
Oh, ready, master.
What's the Betty?
Oh, dear.
What a dirty birdie.
Yahoo! Get along, little doggy. Mosey, sashay, and l'amour to your bunkhouse.
man, in this outfit, I'll have her paying for the marriage license out of her own pocket.
Don't be too sure. Don't forget this is the West, where men are men.
That's what she likes about me. I'm a novelty.
Sorry, partner.
I gotta be careful. If I break my fingers, I'll have to slice the wedding cake with my nose.
Watch your step, Junior.
Oops, whoop.
In the second stall. I'll keep her busy. When you get through, give me a signal.
Right. I'll file a mark on the shoe.
Through Snake Canyon at 9 o'clock.
It's almost 8. You haven't got much time. Thought you said your date was with a dude.
It is.
I don't like my gal getting friendly with other men.
I've told you what to do. Well, do it.
I love the loveliest girl in the world. She's as lovely as the rose that she wears. Here's to the dearest, my one in the world. She's the answer to all of my prayers. California rose, I see the light of love upon your face. California rose, I live to share the warmth of your embrace. Hands that caress me so soft to the touch, lips that possess me and promise so much, near and far away, they know about the rose that's in your hair. Lonely lovers say they'd give the world if only you would care. But darling, you're mine, and my love I'll always share forevermore. My California rose.
I'd like to reward you for your serenade, mister. You know, there isn't another man in all these parts could buy my lips for any amount of money.
Hey, Callahan, if you're not gonna buy, please do not handle the merchandise.
You were late. I didn't think you were coming, Junior.
Thanks kindly for the rose, miss.
Where I hail from, we don't cotton to folks what cotton other folks' gals that don't cotton to folks that cotton to them. That's cotton talk, see?
I apologize, mister.
Oh, you do? Well, then beat it, the whole kit and caboodle of you. That's caboodle talk.
I love coffee, I love cream. Here comes the captain, the other team. Yahoo! Yahoo!
Yahoo!
Help! Where are you?
Up here, Junior. Up here.
Don't go away. I'll be right there.
Why don't you come over here? I just met a bee that wants to tell us all about the birds.
I didn't aim to be late, but I was busy. I was sashaying my Mavericks and branding my stray buckboards till I was plumb horn swoggled. By the time I got to my car, some plum had done swoggled my horn. Well, cozy. Okay, gal, get lucky.
Now, take it easy, Mr. Potter. We have the whole night ahead of us.
The whole night? Well, I gotta work fast, honey.
Now, wait a minute. Come over here. Sit down, and I'll go and mix your cocktail.
Oh, well, don't go, gal.
But the shaker's in the other room.
It's okay. Shake it here. I want to watch. You mind if I smoke? I'd kind of like to keep my lips busy while you're gone. Ah, music. Music in a big yellow moon, moseying atwixt the clouds. There's nothing like music in a big yellow moon to keep a critter hankering for the bunkhouse doing the sagebrush ooh-la-la.
There's a cloud in my valley of sunshine since you told me you found somebody new. There's a cloud in my valley of sunshine and now I'm lonely and I'm blue. Can't we fall in love again all over? Won't you hold me in your arms just like before? 'Cause there's a cloud in my valley of sunshine and I hope you'll bring the sunshine back once more.
To us.
Yes. May we both stay as beautiful as we are tonight. To the future and very wealthy Mrs. Potter. Let's dance, Gal. I'm aiming to sharpen my spurs with some fancy footwork.
All right, I'd love to dance with my future husband.
I'll leave.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Ooh.
There's a cloud in my valley of sunshine since you told me you found somebody new. There's a cloud in my valley of sunshine and now I'm lonely and
you all right?
Can't we fall in love again all over? Won't you hold me in your arms just like before? 'Cause there's a cloud in my valley of sunshine and I hope you'll bring the sunshine back once more. Once more, once more, once more, once more, once more, once more.
For me, I'm driving.
Come on, honey, wake up.
What?
Oh, you're standing on my toe.
Oh, I am? Oh, I'm sorry.
My, it's 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock already?
We've been dancing for an hour, darling. You must have been in a daze ever since I kissed you.
You kiss me? I don't even remember you kissing me.
You don't?
No.
Here, let me refresh your memory.
You know she's going to marry you. You can't trust a woman. I tell you, you ought to be thinking.
Leave me alone. I'm tired.
Dancing all night? Sure you're tired. What am I supposed to do? Sing you a lullaby?
Yeah, sing me a lullaby. Nice, sweet lullaby. Like my daddy used to sing. Every night my daddy used to sing me.
That's it. That's it. Say, Eb. Eb. Eb, wake up. Eb. Eb, listen.
Rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. When the chest falls, the bottom will drop. Don't you get it? That's the way my daddy used to sing it to me. The chest must have a secret bottom.
What?
Don't you listen. Hey, rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. When the chest falls, the bottom will drop.
Eb, wake up. We're rich. The gold must be there. Nothing in the world can stop me now. With this money, I can live.
Our hunch was right. Look at this. It's a marked shoe. I'd like to see her talk her way out of this.
Gravel. We made a very profitable raid last night.
Somebody's wise to us. But who? We gotta find out before they move in.
Boss, we just saw the guitar player. He trailed your horse. The shoe was marked.
The guitar player? A Fed. The guy you got sweet on. You and your plans.
My plans included an alibi. My horse might have been there, but my educated fiancé will prove that I was in his arms at 9 o'clock last night. We're in the clear.
Mike, you're on.
All right. I'll meet you at the bridge as soon as I collect my alibi's tidy little fortune. Guitar player.
We want everybody!
My good friends, doctor. Have no fear, doctor. I will pay, doctor. My dear daddy's bill, doctor. There.
Japanese.
Come here. Welcome. Why go through life with your head in the same shape all the time? Where have you been?
I've been getting the lead.
Lead? What for?
Well, you can't lug an empty chest out of a bank. They get wise to you. You've got to make it look like it's heavy, full of gold, until we can investigate your paw's secret bottom. You...
Yeah, but they'll see me carrying all that stuff to the bank.
Nobody'll see nothing. If you hide the lead in your pants.
Lead in my pants? Why, that's undignified for a Harvard man. Nothing doing. You suggest that once more, and you'll find out the true color of my blood is yellow. Okay, here. Hide the lead. Careful now. What'd you put in there, a battleship?
I tell you, you've got the boy all wrong. He's going over to get his money and count it out. You'll all be paid. Here he comes now.
Tilt. You get paid tonight, folks. I'm loaded. Boy, am I loaded.
Take it easy, son.
Hey. Oh!
You
Oh, don't leave me.
Where'd everybody go? Whoop, steady now. We need too many raisins. I'm breaking out in iron. Just, oh, I'll get it. Okay, fine. I'll get it. Okay, fine, fine. Ah, that's better. Ah, that's swell.
Good afternoon, Miss Mike.
Good afternoon.
Nice white horse you got there.
Yes, I just got him in time to take me to my wedding with Mr. Potter. I had a brown horse, you know, but somebody stole him last night. Shame, I liked him a lot.
You like animals, eh? Then it's only humans you have a beef against.
I find that animals mind their own business.
Then if you don't like humans, why are you getting married?
Oh, I'm not marrying a human. I'm marrying Mr. Potter. I found out last night that when it comes to love, Mr. Potter's an animal, a ball of fire.
What'd you do? Light a torch under him?
You figured everything out, haven't you, Mr. Federal Man?
Federal Man? Why, Miss Mike, you got me all wrong. You see, I'm just a wandering minstrel. Come on, Mike. We'll let you try on the bridal suite for size.
You've got no case, Roy. She has a perfect alibi for last night.
You just keep her in there, Sheriff. I'll break her perfect alibi.
Sounds hollow, but how do you get to it?
When your paw hit something, he really hit it.
Yeah, I remember once Mom told me he hid in a broom closet for 2 weeks. Of course, Mom didn't know the maid was in there with him. The gentle rapping of a woman. Mike. Oh, you darling. Soon I'll have all your money, you darling. Oh, oh, bye now.
Open up or I'll smash this door to smithereens.
Junior! Look here. It's in your paw's handwriting. It says to my young idiot son, Junior, and my old idiot partner, Ebenezer Hawkins. From Paleface.
Oh, it spells idiot with two T's.
Hold him off, Junior. Hold him off.
You always do the dirty work, don't you?
Junior, the gold is here. We're rich. Oh, I found it. We're rich. 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 We're rich.
Check your mainspring. Let me see that.
No, no. You might tell someone where the gold's hid.
Me?
But I won't.
Yeah, but I...
Nobody will see it.
Yeah. Hey, wait a minute.
We're rich.
Like the
Columbia
one.
You can't...
Oh, come in. It was kind of chilly, and we were just burning some old money.
It's empty. That ain't gold.
Ain't is a vulgarism frowned upon in polite circles. Since isn't is the contraction of is not. Remember the verb modifier rule, omnes sanctoris regulorum, which means you ain't laying your dirty paws on me, fat boy. Let's go, boy.
If anything happens to me, boy, you'll never know where the gold is. Well, contact me in Sterling City.
Send a message in the spirit world.
Oh!
gotta get to Sterling City. Whoops. Forgot, no tires. Sterling City, here I come.
Well, he's headed for the desert, Roy.
Yeah. He's our one chance to keep the torch behind bars. We've got to get to him before the buzzards do.
Yeah.
This is great. Fine time to conk out of me, you mechanical rat. Just when the gold is within my reach. I ought to pull the hair out of your seat by the roots. Hey, Martin and Lewis. No hitchhikers, please. It's a state law. Get off. All right, all right. Remember, no smooching in the balcony.
Two days. He must be crazy with the heat by now.
You never can tell. This heat might tend to make him sane.
In the cool of the evening, tell him I'll be there. In the cool of the evening, baby, save a chair.
Crazy.
In the cool.
Stop staring at the menu. If you think I'm a buzzard burger, you're mad. The heat's getting me, I'm telling you. The heat. It's that desert madness. That's what they call it. Yeah. You getting kind of dizzy? Sure. Sure, that's the first sign. It's usually accompanied by a ringing in the ears. Oh, excuse me. Hello? Who? Cambridge 823? No, Penelope. Not now. No, no. I'd like to, but I'm taking a shower with a couple of friends. Uh-huh. Thirsty, aren't you? You want water, huh? Stare. Go ahead. Stare. You're dying for water. 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 It's only a mirage. Thought I'd be fooled, didn't you? I know a mirage when I see one. I'm a college man. Who said you had to dress for dinner? Don't shake your head to me in that tone of voice.
Ask them if they saw a white man go by.
Hey, Ev, where are you? How charming. Looks like a Yale dormitory. Water. I can't drink that. The glass is cracked.
Hey,
hotel, hot and cold running dirt.
Hey, Eb. Eb, are you still here? Or did you find the money?
First mirror I've ever seen with a hangover.
Oh, hi, Eb. Say, I've been looking for you. Would you cut yourself shaving or did you have a high tooth pulled? Eb. Eb. Eb, wake up. Wake up.
He's dead, Junior.
Dead?
It seems that way. I wonder who did it.
Why did you kill him, you fool? I always...
It was his own fault. He wouldn't tell me where the gold was hidden.
When I get out of here...
When you get out of here, the boys and me will be a long way off. You ain't making no plans no more, Mike.
Why don't you start being honest, Potter? You're gonna hang for killing Hawkins, so you might as well come clean. Where was the girl that night about 9 o'clock?
I told you. I told you. We were dancing.
Come on, Potter. We haven't got much time, so start talking and talk fast.
The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog.
Listen, Doc. I'll stay here until I break him down. You report to the governor.
Well, is it all right? He might get away in his car.
Not a chance. I hid the crank. And he can't get away on Trigger because Trigger's a one-man horse and nobody can ride him but me.
Oh, yeah, oh, oh, yeah, oh, yeah, a four-legged friend, a four-legged friend, he'll never let you down. He's honest and faithful right up to the end. That wonderful... Oh, and that four-legged friend. Oh, four-legged friend. That wonderful, wonderful four-legged friend. That four...
Whoa, where you going? Whoa. Down, down, stay on your feet. Hey, don't get nervous now. Hey, where do you think you're going? Huh? Oh, no, you can't go upstairs. You're not ready, sir.
Idea. Oh, Mike, you know I love you. I loved you ever since the first time I saw you, Mike. Ah. Lay off those covers, will you? Lay off the covers, I tell you. You... Want me to steal your teeth? We can do this all night if one of us doesn't give up.
Thank you.
car. I never got that far, Roy. The torch broke out of jail last night.
She'll be heading for Potter.
If she gets there first, we'll never break her alibi.
Meet you in the lobby, third cobweb from the left. Boy, am I happy to see you. Hey, Mike, darling, you came here to save me, huh?
Save you? Who from?
Oh, you know, from the horse lover, old Saddle Soap Britches. He's been keeping me prisoner. He's been trying to get me to say I wasn't with you that night.
Where is he?
I don't know, but he'll be back. We gotta get out of here.
They've been abusing my baby.
I'd hate to tell you who I slept with last night. Those cold hoofs on my back. We'd better go.
This is a nice, quiet place. Let's stay here a while.
Quiet? You can get a room here with an adjoining hole in your head. I'll be right down.
This could be our honeymoon hotel.
Honeymoon? You mean our honeymoon?
Yours and mine.
Without a preacher?
Oh, I asked the preacher to meet us here.
Oh, boy. I know this is going to be a happy marriage because, well, you're a woman and I'm a man and, well, those are the people that usually get married. Mike.
As soon as you get rid of those whiskers,
yeah,
huh?
That'll be easy. I used to pluck turkeys at a Boston market. Don't go away. I'll get dressed.
Ooh. Am I in love? Am I in love? Well, I really wish I knew. All I know is a water sigh when you're standing near. I get a humpty-dumpty feeling. All I know is I wanna sigh like I never sighed before.
Now when you're in love, they say you can tell. You're sick in the heart and you never get well.
Maybe they're right. I wish that I knew why I feel the way I do.
Am I in love? Am I in love?
Well, I leave it up to you.
All I know is I wanna dance when I look at you. I get a hotsy-totsy feeling. All I know is I wanna dance like I've never danced before.
My head's in a whirl, my heart's in a spin. And if I'm in love, I love what I'm in.
I don't know why
I feel this way, but the feeling feels okay.
Are you in love?
Am I in love?
Well, I really couldn't say.
All I know is I wanna sing when you smile at me. I get a la-di-da-di feeling.
All I know is I wanna sing
like I've never sung before.
Got a humpty-dumpty feeling.
Got a hutsy-tutsy feeling.
Got a la-di-da-di feeling too. Am I in love?
Am I in love?
Am I in love?
Am I in love?
Well, I leave it.
I gotta go and freshen up, Junior. But you're a dear.
You're an antelope. Later on, we'll go out in the range and play, huh?
Am I in love? Am I in love? Well, I leave it up to you.
Where's Mike?
Right behind you.
Boy, what a wife! You'll be great when it comes time to chop the wood.
Put him in the chair.
Well, he don't need a haircut. Just trim his lump a little.
Put him in the chair.
Yes, ma'am. Say, what are you gonna do?
Get around behind and hold him.
That's right. Tie him up so he won't bother us. Say, it's gonna be real fun honeymooning in Niagara Falls. My daddy spent a whole week there in his honeymoon, laughing, loving, drinking champagne. He had so much fun, he kind of wished Mother had been with him. You'll love it there. You can see the sights and take a shower at the same time. Hey, he's not tied tight enough. I can still move one of my arms.
Which one?
Oh, this one here, see? Oh, that's it. Now I couldn't get out if I tried. I couldn't. Hey, honey, what am I, a wedding present? Look, I'm gift-wrapped.
Shut up.
Shut up. You can't talk like that to me until after we're married.
She's not going to marry anybody. She's going to kill both of us.
Oh, not me. That'd be silly. Besides, it would take a little of the kick out of my honeymoon.
You're not so smart, Mr. Federal Man. I don't have to kill either one of you gentlemen. They'll do it. They're coming to get the Harvard man, but they'll get you, too. So long, gents.
Just a minute, Miss Delroy.
So you found out my real name, too?
Yes, and I found out that your father was swindled out of his fortune by old Paleface. Mike, the governor knows an injustice was done you. You haven't killed anyone yet, so why start now? I'll do all I can to get you off with a short sentence.
How do I know you're telling the truth about this short sentence, mister?
Cross your heart quick.
You just have to believe me.
We'll talk about that later. I'll stop the Indians before it's too late.
Son of Paleface, there.
Stop. I'm beginning to like it. Well, I must have been crazy. All my life, I'm going around knocking on doors with my hands.
When Trigger sees the spot we're in, he'll get us out. He's got horse sense.
If he had any sense, he wouldn't be a horse. Help! Help! Let me down! My nose will bleed! Close the door. Were you brought up in a barn?
Trigger, the knot. Untie the knot. Hurry up. Bite it. They're coming.
Stop tasting it. Bite it. Fine government agent you are. No guns. You'd think you'd be ready for a situation like this. As a citizen and a taxpayer almost, I'd... Gee, Dad, it's a Winchester. Boy, if you had a bass fiddle, we could hold this fort all winter.
There's too many of them. I can't fight them off alone.
Oh, force yourself.
I'll get you a gun.
I'm right with you, boy. Don't stand there. Get something.
There's your gun. Go get it.
Omnium cum afredo. No dice.
What?
That means, quote, me go out there?
There's another gun. Listen, just how big a coward are you?
Well, I was captain of the Olympic team. Hey, the kid with the bleach blonde tail isn't doing anything. How about him going to get it?
Your dad would sure be ashamed of you.
I certainly am. Paul, Daddy, it's me, your own flesh and idiot.
Don't shame the name of Potter. Go get that gun.
Oh, but those Indians, it's hot out there.
It's hotter where I come from. This H don't stand for Harvard, son. Now get out there.
Yeah, but I'll get killed and I'll be dead like you.
You think that's bad?
You all whistling for me, honey child.
She's in the south end of the furnace. And she's got a younger sister, free red and 21.
I'll get the gun.
I thought you were afraid to die.
Not anymore. One side, boy. I'm taking over.
Thank you.
sure stop those Indians.
Well, I'll stop a couple right now.
Listen, Junior and I will try to hold them off. You ride into Saltbuck Pass and tell Doc Lovejoy to send out the cavalry.
They shot my horse out from under me.
You driver, Junior.
You stole my crank.
I hid it under your seat.
No wonder I've had trouble walking. Come on, Mike. Hey, look. The moose got shot in his jackpot. It's gold. It's my daddy's gold. That's where he hit it. Come on. Well, wait. We need some for our mares, Mike.
Another Paleface. He gone.
Gonna make the whole thing unbelievable. Hand me that bag.
What?
That bag in the back seat. But I guarantee nothing.
The Indians are coming. Get in front and pull.
Get in front and pull. It's a nice thing to say to a Harvard man.
We're moving. We're moving.
Either that or the scenery's slipping.
Junior, I don't know how to drive this thing. Where are you?
I'm down here checking the oil.
Hey, Junior, there's a big rock in the road ahead.
Don't hit it or we'll lose two rear ends. Out! 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 Hey, we got a hitchhiker down here.
Bring the gold upstairs and hurry up. Get the wagon.
Need any help?
Back to the bridge!
Junior, your wife's getting out.
Yeah, she finally served her sentence. I'm gonna take her back to Boston.
You've sure been a faithful husband waiting all these years.
Oh, it wasn't so bad. After all, I saw Mike on visiting days. But you know, it wasn't any fun talking to the woman you love through a wire screen.
Well, here she is now.
Hey.
Yours?
Let's see him top this on television.